Welcome back to Our Issues Milwaukee. I'm your host, Andrea Williams. We've been discussing organizations that provide outstanding programs and services to those living with disabilities. We'll now find out more about Easter Seals Southeast Wisconsin. And joining us is CEO, Mr. Bob Glowacki. How are you?
Great, thanks for having me.
Thank you for being here. And Easter Seals Southeast Wisconsin, it touches the lives of thousands of children and adults with disabilities, and there's a rich history that goes along with that. So if you would, tell us how the Easter Seals name came about.
Well, you know, we had a successful fundraiser, so we named the whole organization after it. So we had a different name until the 1950s, but in the 1930s was the first time a seal, for those of you who are younger, that's something you used to do with mail, and put on the back of an envelope, was presented to Franklin Delano Roosevelt, and that became the Seals, and we were starting to be called the Easter Seals people, because we went out at that time to sell them for a penny, and at that point we became so popular we named ourselves after that, but which sometimes can be a challenge. Because people either think we might be religious or it doesn't tell us people what we do. And that has helped people with challenges such as disabilities to be as independent as possible.
Absolutely. And so let's start off talking about some of the children's services that you have, because you really do have a plethora of programs and services that help so many different people. We'll mention as many of them as we can, but you have early intervention that starts with birth to three-year-olds. So talk a little about that.
In general, Easter Seals, a national organization, began about serving kids. And so our affiliate here in Milwaukee is just the same way. So Birth to Three is a federal program where we are one of the partners in Milwaukee County provide that service. So we provide early education to kids who have been identified with a delay. And it can be not only early education, a special ed teacher comes into the home, assist the family in helping with the therapies, and in addition, we provide occupational, speech, and physical therapies. So about over 300 families every year get the service from us, and it's vital because about 50% of the families we work with, their kids start school on time with their peers.
I love that. And you have ongoing services that include social skill groups and sports clinics, all kinds of things that really are important, because whereas sometimes you look at something like sports clinics and people think that it's all for fun, but really when you talk about playing sports, it really is, that's that structure there that helps individuals move along and grow.
Yeah, the support programs especially come around our autism services, that kids with autism, with those sports clinics are also designed to help it where with them where they may have problems with a lot of noise or other things. So we partner like with Marquette High School and actually the Packer Foundation to do a football clinic. And so the students from Marquette High from the football team come out and they take pictures with the kids, put on Marquette High helmet on them, and I'm an alum so I love it. and it gives them a chance to bring their siblings and just to be typical for a day. And so they run through some of the things, like they're pretending to be a running back, and they go against the blockers, and we have all kinds of volunteers, and it's just a day for their families, because families with autism have severe challenges at times. One study found that some moms experience like combat stress. For as much as that goes on in the home, all the things that they're managing, and it's just one day when we can try and reduce that stress a little bit, and the other things you're talking about, some of those playing in the sandbox skills, about waiting your turn, and taking turns, and playing with others, those are important, because people with autism sometimes don't have that connection to others, and that makes them different in the classroom, and we want them to feel comfortable in the classroom.
Absolutely. So you have teen and family services, so I'm sure that's a long list of things, but if you could give us an idea of some of the things you cover.
I think the things we wrap up, we instead of, you know, at each point in life, for example, our autism services, we do applied behavioral analysis in the home, helping young, and that can go up into the teen years. And we do about 30,000 hours of therapy in the home, and that's a service anybody can tap in Southeast Wisconsin. When we talk about some of the other services, many of them are camps and day camps and after schools, just providing a place for kids to be that's safe and where people understand what challenges they may have, whether it be behavioral or special food conditions or the disability where we might provide cares. Anything we can do for those programs to help them be more inclusive and invite siblings in and others, we're all about that. But part of it is really, that's kind of a twofold. We're trying to help the child, but which we are, but it's also for the parent. It's the respite they need to continue to work, continue to do what they need to do, provide for their families.
Yes, indeed. And you also cater to adults, seniors, military, and veterans. And if you could explain the importance of being able to help individuals along that spectrum.
Right. At Easter Seals, I always say we help people in the first steps in life to the last steps in life.
Okay.
And so I feel like, you know, we have our lily flower at the center of our logo, and there's just a place for everybody on the lily, which means that if the family needs support, whether it be that respite program, well, we also do workforce, or we provide adult days. So they don't have to go to a new provider. They can go with the people they know, or if they want to make sure, they can at least ask us. And we'll say, hey, we have other friends. You might want to choose this provider. We've been around. So it gives them a sense of continuity. Really, as Easter Seals, we talk about people being at life's moments. All of us experience having the first child and the first child going to school. Add to that having a disability. And as a parent, how do you know what's the right thing to do?
Right.
Easter Seals at each of those moments where we can be assistance, we can be help, hope, and answers to help an individual and a family figure out what's best at the next step in life so they don't feel alone. Because we, as you were mentioning, we have 80 years of doing this, mm-hmm. that we can apply it and then the family can make their own decisions.
I think it's awesome. There are a couple of programs that fall under the umbrella of helping all the individuals mm-hmm. that I had named. Mm-hmm. You've got Camp Yellow Ribbon, mm-hmm. and that sounds really interesting and fun.
Right.
So.
It's our only overnight camp
okay.
That runs for 4 days, and it's just for families of the military.
Okay.
And so we get support from CAPCO locally, as well as our own staff. Many of our staff flex their hours so that they don't cost us additional hours to be there overnight. So these individuals, and the part about it, many of the military families in our area, we're not by a military base.
Okay.
Their kids have no natural supports. This brings in people really from across the state so that these kids know there's other families like them who have experienced their parents being out of their lives for 18 and 24 months and having that loss, and there's somebody else who understands them. And we partner with other organizations like Dry Hooch of America and the Mental Health America of Wisconsin, where they provide different parts of the program so that these kids, these 50 kids usually, get the best experience possible. They just have fun, and their families are just so happy when we do family day and they come. And even usually we can get a local military unit to show up and bring in like rations that their parents might have been having in Iraq and Afghanistan.
Wow.
So they can kind of experience what it's like to drive a tank or to be in a Humvee.
Wow.
And it's really exciting, and it really is something where we've had the governor come. I mean, everybody really wants to support these kids, and that's one thing about Easter Seals and our national effort on military and vets. Easter Seals understands families,
mm-hmm.
and too much our VA and other services are great, but they're only focused on the veteran. And there's a spouse, and there's kids, and there's a whole lot of dislocation. So Easter Seals, we're using our core competencies in helping families just to focus on this group of families and use what we already know to help in their transition.
I think that's an excellent point to bring out, because really when someone is sent away mm-hmm. To go fight, it does
yeah.
affect the entire yeah. family, so that's great.
Right.
We were talking about camp, mm-hmm. so
yeah.
that's a great way to go. The summer months are, I think,
yes.
going by the weather lately.
right, yeah. It will come sooner or later.
I think summer is on
right.
its way, but you guys do provide adult recreation to individuals mm-hmm. who are 16 and up. Talk
right.
about that.
Well, we do two things, and our recreation programs are like all year round. So
mm-hmm.
we have our four day camps that are both in Milwaukee and Waukesha, different parts of the community, so that we can help families. One serves between ages 7 to 21, and one does the entire lifespan, which I don't know how quite we do that, but my staff are amazing. But we make that happen, but during the year, them, we have a regular recreation program. It's called the Willoway Centers, which we manage from Milwaukee County. They're at each end of the county.
Mm-hmm.
And for that, we have everything from a prom to dances. I mean, our dances attract 150 individuals every Friday, as well as photography classes and all kinds of other things that we do, community outings. And so that's there for folks with disabilities where maybe they'd like to hang with folks that are just like them.
Mm-hmm.
We'd much rather have that they go on the Brewers games and go to Summerfest and do everything inclusive, but somehow sometimes they just want to hang with people they're comfortable with.
Mm-hmm.
And again, it can also provide respite for those families, because many times parents who have a child with a disability, the child stays in the home much longer. Well, nowadays some people never leave the home, but even with these children, now maybe they stay with the home in home until they're maybe like 30 or 35 years.
Yeah.
So it kind of gives mom and dad a little break. I have one board member who's wonderful, and he makes a donation every year because he's like, then my brother-in-law and I can go out for dinner, and we can, because at that same time his daughter is coming to one of our dances, and
that's
they know
awesome.
They're cared for, and he can be a brother to his brother-in-law.
Good stuff. And you do have a program guide that mm-hmm. maps out all the opportunities that are associated with the Willoway
right.
Recreation Center. And an important point to bring out is annual health care costs of obesity that are related to disability. Mm-hmm. are estimated at approximately $44 $1 billion and impair an individual's opportunities for greater independence. So that's almost like a double-edged sword there, because if an individual is not able to get up and exercise and do the things that are important, then they may be in a scenario where they're gaining weight, and then you've got obesity, heart disease, all these things.
Right.
You are combating that with some of your programming.
Yeah. The recreation, I mean, it's getting around, it's moving, it's having somewhere to go. It's, you know, we have exercise classes, we do different things that really do help on those kind of things, because otherwise, you know, if an individual disability is not challenged at home, they could get a sedentary lifestyle, and that's, you don't have to have a disability to know what happens if
that's
you're on the couch
truth.
Too long.
Yes.
So those types of things keep the mind active and the body.
Mm-hmm. And then finally, not finally, because I do have a couple of other things that I do want to bring up to you. You've got a signature program called LilyWorks, and if you could explain what that is and how that helps individuals to be able to get into the workforce and get that training.
Easter Seals is kind of, we're locally, I think we're a pretty amazing agency.
And
one of the things that we did in 2010 was to merge with what was then the Waukesha Training Center.
Mm-hmm.
And they had a workforce program, and they had some businesses, but they weren't really branded, they weren't really together, they didn't have a presence. We've really invested in those businesses now, and we rebranded them as LilyWorks. And so it does offer with the people we serve an opportunity for training, either short-term or long-term, to help them get in the hospitality industry. It now includes, after the support of donors across the area with $1 million, for us to have built out a new LilyWorks Conference Center in Waukesha, right near the airport, where we have room for 120 people in a state-of-the-art facility. But the people who are going to serve you food, the people who are going to pass your hors d'oeuvres, are going to be folks with some challenges.
Okay.
But the great thing about it, some of the folks, we keep losing them because they keep on getting hired. They're getting the right training in this commercial kitchen that we built out, so that now they're being hired by local restaurants, and they're getting employment, and which is really what we want.
That is what it's all about. And you provide planning and assessment and pre-vocational services. And before we run out of time, I do want to give people an opportunity to mark their calendars, because here's where they can help make a difference and get involved with the organization. You've got your Easter Seals Walk With Me. Fill us in.
Walk With Me, you're walking with our ambassadors. Four individuals who represent what we do, and we're going to do that June 24th at the zoo. We're saying we're going to have it's going to be a barrel of monkeys. We're going to have so much fun. This is our first year at the zoo. We've been doing it for a number of years.
Mm-hmm.
It's a key fundraiser and a friendraiser.
Bringing
together people around. And also, too, these ambassadors get to tell you their stories and how Easter Seals has impacted them, but how they're heroes, too. And when we walk, you're walking with them, and you're making a difference in their lives.
That is good stuff, and it's a great way to wrap up. I did want to mention that your adult services supports adults with severe cognitive and physical disabilities, and you've got different locations around Wisconsin and West Dallas, Tulsa, Waukesha, and Kenosha.
Yes.
So, of course, they can go to your website for all the details. I thank you so much for stopping by. Bob Glowacki is the CEO of Easter Seals Southeast Wisconsin. For more information on anything we've discussed, you can give them a call at 414-449-4444 or log on to EasterSealsWise.com. That's going to do it for today's show. I'm your host, Andrea Williams. As always, thank you for watching, and I hope you join us again next week as we take another look at our issues in Milwaukee. Have a great day.